Hello, and welcome to our video on webcam-based eye tracking. My name is Divya Seernani, and I am a senior product specialist here at iMotions. Spent many years working with eye tracking both within and outside academia. In this video, we will discuss the technical differences between infrared eye trackers and webcam-based eye tracking. Look at the claims made by webcam eye tracking algorithms regarding accuracy, why some webcam eye tracking algorithms can be unreliable, and how to get good data. Then we will take a look at what kind of information you can expect to get from webcam eye tracking, when it is appropriate to use webcam eye tracking in research, and finally have a look at what the future holds for webcam-based eye tracking. Webcam eye tracking uses computer vision to track eye movements by analyzing the video captured by the web camera and detecting the eyes of the participants. This can be a regular consumer webcam that is integrated into a laptop. The resolution of the camera actually matters much less than what one might expect. Because webcam eye tracking doesn't rely on special hardware, it makes it possible to do eye tracking remotely by having study participants use their own computer as long as they have a webcam connected. Webcam-based eye tracking still uses calibration points to learn what the eyes of each participant look like when they are looking at different points on the screen. This is also true for infrared eye trackers, and the whole process takes less than a minute. The technology has been around for more than 10 years, but only within the recent years, due to advances in computer vision technology, has it become a serious solution to consider for both academia and commercial applications. But let's look at some of the differences between webcam-based eye trackers and infrared eye trackers. Both infrared eye trackers and webcam-based eye trackers rely on a camera to collect eye tracking data. The difference is that webcam-based eye tracker only has a light available in the environment of the participant. The infrared eye tracker emits near-infrared light at the participant. This is then reflected in the eyes of the participant and captured by the camera. Because infrared eye trackers have their own light source and at times use more than one camera to capture the reflected light, they generally perform better and more consistently than webcam-based eye trackers and are often less sensitive to people wearing glasses. However, there are certain situations where even an infrared eye tracker will struggle, for example, when there's a lot of direct sunlight present in the environment. Because there is infrared light in sunlight, the light emitted from the eye tracker itself can be drowned out by the infrared light present in the sunlight and thus cause it to collect less accurate or in some instances useless data. Because most classic eye tracking studies take place indoors in a controlled environment, this isn't a problem. But it could pose a problem if you were trying to collect data outdoors on a sunny day. Some eye tracking glasses that rely on infrared get around this problem by using tinted lenses, thus filtering out some of the sunlight. But this is obviously not a solution for mounted eye trackers used in screen-based research. Another key difference between webcam-based eye trackers and infrared eye trackers is the sample rate that they operate at. A standard web camera will operate at a sample rate close to 30 Hz, but an infrared eye tracker can run anything from 30, 50, 100, 250, or even 1,200 Hz. The key difference here is that the amount of information a high-end infrared eye tracker captures is many times greater than what a web camera captures. So does that mean that webcam eye trackers can't be used for eye tracking? No, not at all. In fact, there are some infrared eye trackers with lower sampling rates. So if you want to study visual attention and gaze behavior, for example, to see where people look on a website, video, or ad, then 30 Hz can be enough. Remember, this is the same as 30 frames per second. So for every second, the eye position is calculated 30 times. But if you want to study something that requires high temporal resolution, such as rapid eye movements like saccades, then 30 Hz is not enough, and you will be looking at a high-end eye tracker that samples at 250 Hz instead. For eye trackers where the computational power isn't embedded in the hardware itself, the sampling rate can often be increased via software settings. Many webcams will allow you to turn up the sample rate, but this, of course, will also increase the computational power needed and will increase the sources of noise in the image. This is more than what a standard laptop can handle and is not a viable solution when doing remote studies where participants are self-guided in conducting the study. Also, it is important to remember that increasing sampling rate does not increase accuracy. It only increases the information available to calculate the true fixations. Without high accuracy, it doesn't matter if you have a high sampling rate, as it will not be enough for studying rapid eye movements. The resolution of a camera affects how much data it captures per frame. But because camera-based eye trackers are not just looking at the reflection of light in the eye, but using an algorithm to detect the facial features and eye position, it actually doesn't need that higher resolution to capture the information needed. Most web cameras use standard high-definition resolution, which is 1024 by 768 pixels. This is the same as what many high-end infrared eye trackers use, although some will run at 1920 by 1080. The higher resolution, the more accuracy can potentially be achieved. But the underlying algorithms are a lot more important to achieving a high accuracy. So don't let a lower resolution fool you into thinking that the data will be much worse. The hardware for infrared eye trackers is of course built to excel at tracking head and eye movements. Some high-end infrared eye trackers come with two cameras, and some even allow for more cameras to be connected at a time, creating a world model. This provides the eye tracker a better chance at capturing each eye at the best angles possible. The extra camera makes them less sensitive to head movements, which often can be a problem when it comes to eye tracking. Now, you might think that the dedicated infrared eye trackers have all the advantages over a camera-based eye tracker. But not so fast. Web cameras are naturally positioned at the optimal place for capturing a person sitting in front of a computer screen. They are subtle and non-intrusive, and people are used to them being there. Infrared eye trackers, like this one, have to be mounted to the screen or be placed on the laptop and require a wired connection and, in some cases, the need for their own power supply. This makes the setup a lot less intuitive and also makes for a less natural experience for the participants. The software is really where a lot of the magic happens when it comes to eye tracking. Of course, the hardware is important in order to capture as much data as possible, but the calculations to understand where the eye is looking, the distance to the screen, blink rate, and much more is what makes the big difference. There are a number of different eye tracking algorithms available. What they all have in common is that they rely on computer vision to recognize head and eye movements. The larger and more diverse the data set is that the algorithm has trained on, the better it is at performing its computer vision task in different types of environments, no matter lighting or the age, race, gender of the participant, or if they were wearing glasses or have facial hair. This is where a lot of the open source webcam eye tracking algorithms can struggle to deliver, as they often are not trained on large and diverse data sets. This results in a less robust solution and less accurate eye tracking. We have developed our own webcam-based eye tracking algorithm at iMotions and have trained it on one of the best data sets commercially available, which encompasses 4.5 million images. On top of our improvements to our web eye tracking algorithm, this has resulted in what we believe to be not only the most accurate eye tracking algorithm for web eye tracking available, but also the most inclusive and unbiased, ensuring great eye tracking data for all participants, no matter color or race. There are a lot of different claims regarding webcam accuracy. Some will tell you that they are accurate to a certain percentage of the screen. Others that it is within a certain amount of pixels, and yet others report their accuracy in degrees. Ideally, we would have loved to give you a comparison of the different accuracy claims that various webcam eye tracking algorithms have, but unfortunately, there doesn't seem to be much publicly available about the methods used to calculate their accuracy. Questions such as how many people participated in the validation process, what demographics are represented, was the validation in a controlled environment where everything was set up for optimal performance and accuracy, or was it in a natural environment? We also don't know what screen sizes were included in their validation studies, which again means we don't know what they are actually measuring. We have chosen to be completely transparent about the methods we use to calculate the accuracy of the iMotions WebET algorithm, as well as measure the performance on a number of important metrics and make them publicly available. This allows us to have an open discussion with academics and users of our software to set guidelines for further development of our WebET algorithm and progress the field together. The average accuracy of the third iteration of iMotions WebET in a controlled environment with ideal conditions is 2.2 dBA. dBA is short for degrees of visual angle. The angle is measured at the point of the participant's eye. The further away someone sits from the screen, the larger area 1 degree will cover. The closer to the screen, the smaller an area will be covered. We have a white paper which you can find on our website which goes more in depth with accuracy under ideal conditions and in non-ideal conditions. 2.2 dBA sounds impressive for a webcam eye tracker, especially when we knew that this was significantly better than our previous WebET algorithm, which was comparable to a lot of other webcam eye trackers available on the market. This is why we wanted to stress test our new webcam eye tracker and do a validation study in the wild where we had no control of the lighting, screen size, camera used, or how the participant behaved during the data collection. So we ran a validation study with 255 participants with a wide demographic representation as possible. The study lasted for 10 minutes and required the participants to look at a series of GIFs and a couple of videos. Most of the participants had no prior experience with eye tracking studies and would therefore not have been aware of the importance of sitting still for the entire duration of the study. We didn't know what to expect when sampling so many different participants. But luckily, we found that the accuracy was still holding up even when we had no control over the environment or the participants. Out of the 255 participants, we found that 92% had an accuracy below 5 dBA, 70% an accuracy below 3 dBA, and 50% of the participants had a dBA less than 2. This is very impressive considering that the average dBA we measured in our control study was 2.2 dBA. Eye color is one of the things we know from experience can negatively affect the accuracy of collected eye tracking data. This is mainly due to a bias towards a white demographic in the training data used for many eye tracking algorithms. We wanted to make sure that the new version of our webcam eye tracker wasn't suffering from a bias which essentially would discriminate against certain demographics. As you can see in this chart, we didn't see any significant differences in the eye tracking accuracy across the different eye colors. However, we did notice some differences when participants were wearing glasses. On average, this came down to 1 degree worse accuracy. However, considering the overall accuracy performance of the algorithm, this was still an impressive result. While self-reported lighting and the duration of the study did not affect the accuracy in any significant way, these may affect the studies indirectly. For example, shadows on the face making the iris difficult to identify, or long studies making participants restless, worsening the user experience, can cause participants to move. Thus, for best quality data, we recommend short studies and prompts for participants to check if their faces and eyes are correctly detected. So compared to an infrared eye tracker, is this good? Yes and no. The accuracy is far below what you can expect from a high-end infrared eye tracker running at 60 Hz or more. However, if you compare it with an entry-level infrared eye tracker, you start being able to compare the results, and then it becomes more a question of what webcam-based eye tracking can offer that a traditional hardware eye tracker cannot. So it is really up to you to judge if a slight loss of accuracy outweighs the benefits of a completely browser-based data collection solution where you can recruit participants from anywhere in the world and have them do eye tracking studies using nothing but their own computer. We are doing our bit to make sure webcam-based eye tracking becomes a reliable research tool and have developed iMotions Online as a serious web-based research tool that not only has unparalleled eye tracking via iMotions 3.0, but also features Affectiva's Aftex for emotion recognition, a study builder and a powerful survey tool, which allows for qualitative as well as quantitative data collection together with eye tracking studies. If you are interested in finding out more about our solution, please go to our website, iMotions.com. Thank you for watching.
Mm-hmm.